Hey guys, what's up? How are you all doing? And if you're new here, hi, welcome to the channel. It's nice having you here. So subscribe to the channel and join us. Let's shoot. Anyway, in this video, I'll be talking about a laptop that I think is one of the best. Scratch that. I know it's one of the best budget laptops you can buy right now. The name of this 7-year-old laptop is the Lenovo Thinkpad T440p. It has four USB ports, a fingerprint scanner, dedicated graphics, an optical drive, and a fantastic keyboard. So let's get to it, shall we? My name is Yudi. I talk about tech. Let's think. Pad. So about 2 weeks ago, I made a video on the best budget phones you can buy. In that video, I mentioned both newer budget phones and older flagships. But if you're buying a budget laptop, it is always better to buy older quality laptops. You get better processors, or like the Intel Pentium you get with newer budget laptops. You'll probably get a dedicated GPU. You get more and better hardware, and these older laptops are easily upgradable. And the Lenovo ThinkPad T440p tick all those boxes. And what's more, you can get the Lenovo ThinkPad T440p for under $250. I got mine for exactly 100,000 naira, $220. So first, let's see out the specs of the Lenovo ThinkPad T440p. It's a 14-inch notebook, so it has a 14-inch LCD screen with a resolution of 1366 by 768. It has a 720p webcam. It is completely made out of plastic, but it's a good kind of plastic. It's quality rugged plastic. It's running Windows 10, and my variant here has the Intel Core i7-4600M CPU at 2.9 GHz and turbo speed of 3.6 GHz, NVIDIA 730M GPU with 1 GB of dedicated video memory, 8 GB of RAM, 500 GB hard disk drive, and it is powered by a 4900 mAh 6-cell battery. Let's take a look at the ports and the entire system. At the right side, we have the 10/16 lock, two USB 2.0 ports, one of which is always on, which simply means that even when the laptop is turned off, it will still work. You could use it to charge your phone, for example. And still on the left, on the right side, we have the optical disk drive. At the back, we have the Ethernet port, DC in, that's your power port, and the vent. At the left side, we have the second vent, the VGA port, headphone jack, mini display port, two USB 3.0 ports, making a total of four USB ports, and the SD card reader. So there is no HDMI port. If you really need the HDMI port, you need to get one of these, display port to HDMI dongle. And at the front, we have the speaker grill. Like I said, it's completely made out of plastic, but it's strong plastic. You don't have to baby this laptop. It's really durable. And the top of the laptop feels like a matte finish. The screen on the ThinkPad T440p is okay. It's 14 inches and it has a resolution of 1366 by 768. It's not touch enabled, so nothing special. And viewing angles are not that great. But the screen can be upgraded. More to that towards the end of the video, so watch to the end. The hinge itself can move up to 180 degrees. And the hinge itself is also very strong. You can see how the hinge has held up over the years. This laptop is very durable. And yes, you can open up the laptop with just one hand. A lot of people seem to care about that. Well, you can. The laptop is quite thick at 1.2 inches thick. And for me, I don't mind that. The laptop again isn't heavy. For me, it's about 2.1 kilograms. Opening up the laptop, we see the keyboard. The fantastic keyboard. The chiclet keyboard is well made and reflects typical ThinkPad quality. The keys offer moderate keystroke and a good pressure point, and the stroke noise is quite quiet. The keyboard is firm and does not give easily. The key distance or key travel is also very good. There is no number pad, and I actually prefer this. The numpad is already pretty useless to me since I never use it. My model does not have a keyboard light, but I plan to swap out the keyboard for one that does. Below the keyboard is the touchpad, which has a 3.9 by 3 inch surface with excellent swiping capabilities. Multiple finger gestures are clearly recognized even when only using fingertips. Also, the entire input can be pressed down. To the top left corner of the keyboard, we have the power button, and below that, we have the fingerprint scanner. The fingerprint scanner works quite well. You swipe your finger across it and you're in. And because of the fingerprint scanner, I can't remember the last time I used my password. Wait, what's my password? The ThinkPad T440p also has a SIM card slot, mini SIM card slot. So if you want 3G connectivity on your laptop without the need for Wi-Fi and you have a spare SIM, just take out the battery and slot in your SIM. But do note it's not 4G, so even if you put a 4G SIM, you'll get 3G signal. Now, for the elephant in the room, performance. How does the ThinkPad T440p perform? Well, my model has 8GB of RAM and the Intel Core i7-4600M CPU running at 3.6 GHz. It also has a dedicated GPU, the NVIDIA GT730M with 1GB of DDR3 memory. Apps open up quite fast. Microsoft Edge, LibreOffice, which is basically just a free version of Microsoft Office, Visual Studio Code, Shortcuts, which is one of the free video editors I use, Netflix, and so on. They all open up quite quickly, under 2 seconds, and they run very well too. If you watch my previous video on the best free video editors, I'll leave a link to that video in the description. You know I use Shortcut to edit my videos and it works fine. So for light applications like Edge, LibreOffice, and do I say medium apps like Shortcuts, this laptop will run them flawlessly. Now for more demanding apps like DaVinci Resolve, this laptop will struggle. This is the only reason why I don't use DaVinci Resolve to edit. I mostly use DaVinci Resolve for noise reduction and adding text. DaVinci Resolve takes about 26 seconds to open, and editing videos will be possible but difficult. Video playback will become choppy and it will become as low as 10 frames per second. Now, how about gaming? Yes, I use this laptop to play games, but I am no gamer. I play just one game on my laptop, PES, Pro Evolution Soccer. Its total size is just about 6GB and it plays great at 60fps even on high settings. I have really enjoyed playing PES on the ThinkPad T440p. I've had no issues. Gameplay is smooth. I tried putting a more demanding game, FIFA 19. Its total size was about 40GB. It was playable, but not as good as PES. FIFA 19 was only playable on low settings, and I deleted it because I don't like FIFA gameplay. And I'd like to know, are you Team FIFA or Team PES? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you want me to do a separate gaming review of the ThinkPad T440p, let me know in the comment section below. I'll get right to it. Now, how about battery life? The ThinkPad T440p has a 4900 mAh battery, a 6-cell battery, and it will last for about 5 hours on light usage. So let's say I was just typing up a document, it will last for about 5 hours. But let's say I were gaming, it will last for roughly 2 hours. So I am impressed with the battery life. It's not great, but it's good for a 7-year-old laptop. I said something at the beginning of this video. Older notebooks are easily upgraded, and the ThinkPad T440p is also very easy to upgrade. Taking out just 2 screws and sliding out the back cover, you have access to everything. I plan to upgrade to 16GB of RAM and a 500GB SSD. And if you crave for more battery life, you can easily swap out this battery for a bigger 9-cell battery. The ThinkPad T440p is no M1 MacBook Pro Max Ultra 5G. This is a ThinkPad notebook from 2013. But for $250, I am very happy I got it. Very good performance, wide selection of ports, excluding HDMI, excellent keyboard, a very unique trackpad, a fingerprint scanner, and good battery life. So, if you're a student, a programmer, someone who does a lot of office work, or you're even a casual gamer on an extreme budget, the ThinkPad T440p would be a great buy. If you enjoyed this video, give this video a like, and also tell me in the comment section what 2 features of the ThinkPad T440p you like the most. Is it the CPU, the GPU, the fingerprint scanner, the SIM card slot, or the trackpad? I don't know. Whatever it is, let me know in the comment section down below. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be one of the first to know when I upload my next video. My name is Yudi, this is Yudi Shu. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in my next video.